10 Best Advice to Pass a Road Driving Test in UAE. Now that you are on a road test, congratulations on passing your theory and parking exam. Some of us got lucky during our first try, but some don't, so let me give you the best 10 advice to pass a driving road test in UAE. Think that we are a being of habit, and anything you do without thinking about it is a form of habit. That's what the examiner want to see on us while taking an exam, which it is already embedded in you, the habit of a good and safe driver, and for it to be a habit, you have to redo it over and over again in your mind. Number 1. Review everything even at the comfort of your couch. Remember how you enter your car, how you put on your seat belt, adjusting your seat, how you adjust the mirrors. The best thing is to reenact the scenario of opening and entering the door of your car, then adjusts your seat and seat belt. Last thing to adjust is your mirror. Number 2. Always imagine that you are driving. What you need to do when the examiner instructed you a direction. First you need to check your mirror, center, left or right, then your shoulder or blind spot, and then make a signal if the road is clear and make your turn. Number 3. Always prepare your body many days before the time of the exam, by becoming active every day on the time that you know the time of the exam will occur on test date. This will prepare your mind and body to be active during those hours of the day. It is better to have a good night's sleep and not to worry about anything, and better to take the exam in the morning time so your mind is still fresh. Don't bother to listen to any subliminal sounds for better driving, that will just going to affect your concentration. Number 4. Plan ahead for the road that you're going to take the test. Most of the road for the exam is a different route than the one you are training on, and familiarity is the key to pass the exam. Google Earth Street View will be a big help for you to be familiarized on those road. You can check the signs, road ends, signals and road markings through Google Earth Street View. Read and review the driver handbook for road priority rules. Number 5. Especially if you are taking an automatic transmission test, always remember that there are different type of shifter according to model and brand of the vehicle. Sometimes the vehicle that you are using on your training or the vehicle that you're familiar with are different or have an added functions than the vehicle that you're going to use for the test. It is clear that once the examiner corrected you for the shifting position, you are automatically failed. Number 6. During the exam, while driving out from a parking, check both sides of the road before going out and don't accelerate your car while backing if not necessarily, even if you don't see any car behind you. Number 7. Importantly, don't take off your hands on the steering wheel. Sometimes out of nervousness, our hands gets really sweaty and it will affect our handling of the vehicle, so out of a habit you will tend to rub one of your hand through your pants. The best way to deal with this is to wear a proper driving glove even during the training. It will also help you to have a better grip. Number 8. You cannot hit what you can see. Always remember that when you're driving, your eyes and head should always move and scanning your surroundings, and with the help of the mirror you can see what is around you, and the faster the car, the further you must look ahead in advance while checking your surroundings. Number 9. Always look for the signs and road markings is very important. During the road shoulder, don't cross the solid line and make sure to check the surroundings first before merging onto the main road. Remember that your eyes and head are likely when you are watching a live tennis, your eyes and head are moving past following the movement of the ball. Like merging on a roundabout, you have to look for the coming car and the car in front of you. Number 10. Choose a time that the sun is not blinding you during your driving exam, but if you have no choice, then lower your sun visor before you drive the car. If you're wearing a grade glasses, it is better if it has an anti-glare and UV on protection in it. Many people I knew gave up after a series of failure. They said that maybe they will spend much more time and money if they retake another exam, but if you don't succeed after continuously failing, Give it a rest first, relax and try it again after a few months. Think and recall the moment why did you fail on the first place. Anyways, the validity and expiration of your student card are 6 months prior to your last test. Just don't give up your dreams to drive in UAE.
If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to this channel or comment down below for any suggestion.